Good morning. Let's continue with the previous class. In previous class, we have discussed about evapotranspiration, measurement of evapotranspiration, and factors affecting evapotranspiration. Now, in today's class, we shall solve few problems. The first problem is determine the consumptives for the details for a certain crop given in the table below. Using Bentley-Kriddle's equation, and also he has given the crop factor. Bentley-Kriddle's equation, K, the crop factor is 0.75. K is the crop factor is 0.75. Now, by using the Bentley-Kriddle's equation, here we need to find out the consumptives. What is consumptives? Nothing but evapotranspiration. Consumptives is nothing but evapotranspiration. Here we need to use the evapotranspiration, or here we need to find out the potential evapotranspiration. Then he has given some of the details, various monthly temperature, because in every month there will be average temperature, and monthly percentage dead time hours of the years, because during summer the percentage of sunshine is more, during June, July, August the percentage sunshine is less. Now let us write the question in detail. Month, let us consider it as November, December, January and February. He has given 4 months, means November, December, January, February. Now, what is the monthly mean temperature of November? Is 19 degree. December is 16 degree. January is 12.5 degree. February is 13 degree. Because here he has given in the unit of degree. Next, monthly percentage daytime hours of the year, means you all know that in summer monthly percentage daytime hours of the year, it is nothing but the sunrise at 6 a.m. and the sunset will occur at 6:30 or 7 p.m. In sometimes the sun will rise at 6:30 or 7 a.m. and the sun will set at 6 p.m. Like that, monthly percentage sunlight hours of the years, what is this value? Is 7.19%, 7.15%, 7.30% and 7.03%. 7.03%. Now, this is the full question. In question, he has given the K equals to 0.75 and he has mentioned the various months from November to February, and he has also mentioned the average temperature of every month, 19 degree in November, 16 degree in December, 12.5 degree in January and 13 degree in February. And percentage sunshine hours, is nothing but 7.19%, 7.15%, 7.30%, 7.03%. It is represented by symbol P. It is represented by symbol T. T is the temperature, P is the percentage sunshine hours. Okay. Now we need to find out the consumptives. Consumptives is nothing but evapotranspiration. For finding out evapotranspiration, there are two formulas. One is Cu equals to KPTm by 100. You can find out the consumptives or evapotranspiration by using this formula, or you can use the other formula, Cu equals to k into f, here f is equals to p by 40 bracket 1.8 t plus 32, 1.8 t plus 32. Here t will measure in terms of month, inches per month. Here you are going to measure the CU with respect to centimeter per day, centimeter per day. Both formulas are same, but you are going to measure the evapotranspiration in inch per month. Here you are going to measure the evapotranspiration in centimeter per day. Okay. Now we shall use this formula. One thing you need to remember in question, he has mentioned the temperature in centigrade, but by using this empirical formula, you should use it, or you should convert the centigrade to Fahrenheit. You should convert the temperature from centigrade to Fahrenheit. For that, 1.8 plus 32. 1.8 plus 32. What is P? P is nothing but the monthly percentage daytime hours of the years. P is the monthly percentage daytime of the years. What is F? F is the monthly consumptive use factor. F is the consumptive use factor. Consumptive use factor. Here, this is the question. We shall solve the problem by using this formula. Cu equals to K into F. Here, F is nothing but the consumptive use factor or monthly consumptive use factor. P by 40 bracket 1.8 T plus 32. Here, we know the value of P. Here, we know the value of T. Now, we can find out F. F equals to P by 40 into 1.8 T plus 32. Here, what is the value of P? 7.19 by 40 into 1.8. Here, what is the temperature in November? It is 19 degree plus 32. We'll get some answer. Like that, similarly for December, 7.15 by 40 into 1.8 into 16 plus 32. Similarly, in case of January, 7.30 is the percentage sunshine in January into 1.8 into what is the temperature in January? 12.5 degree plus 32. What is the temperature in February? It is 13 and percentage sunshine is 7.03. 7.03 by 40. 1.8 into 13 plus 32. Now we need to find out the value of F. What is the value of F? It is, for November it is 11.9. For December it is 10.9. For January it is 9.95. And for February, it is 9.74. You solve it by your own through Calci. Okay, for November, the consumptive factor is 11.9. For December, the consumptive factor is 10.9. For January, the consumptive factor is 9.95. And for February, the consumptive factor is 9.74. Summation of all this consumptive factor will give us around 42.4 42.49 is the sigma f value. Sigma f value. Now you know the value of f, you know the value of k, which is given in the question. Now you can find out the Cu. Cu equals to k into f. Here the f is k into summation f. Summation is f is nothing but average consumptive factor of 4 months: November, December, January, and February. The summation f is 42.49. What is the value of k? Is 0.75. K is 0.75. Next, what is the value of summation f? It is 42.49. If you multiply this two, you will get Cu. Cu is nothing but consumptives or evapotranspiration. Evapotranspiration equals to, once you calculate, you will get the value of consumptives or evapotranspiration. What is that? 31.87. Centimeter of water is evaporated, water is used, or 31.87 amount of water is used by the soil, by the plant, and some amount is transpirated and some amount get evaporated. It is a consumptive use. We shall continue with the next problem. Wheat is to be grown at certain place. The use of climatologic conditions of which tabulated below, determine the evapotranspiration. We can also call it as consumptive use. Evapotranspiration by making use of Benley-Creedle's equation. By using Benley-Creedle's equation, we can find out evapotranspiration. And crop factor K equals to 0.8. It is very similar to previous problem. The only change is here the K is 0.8. Also, he has mentioned that he has given the tabular column. The temperature reading and P. What is P? P is the percentage sunshine hour. It is a monthly percentage sunshine hour represented in P. Now we need to find out F. F is nothing but the consumptive use factor. By using P by 40 into 1.8 times temperature plus 32. Here the T is the temperature. Okay, now let us discuss what is the, what are the various temperature given in November, December, January, February, and what is the various percentage daylight hours in November, December, January, February. The temperature in November is 18 degree, the temperature in December is 15 degree, the temperature in January is 13.5 degree, the temperature in February is 14.5. Now what is the monthly percentage sunshine hours? It is represented by symbol P. It is 7.2%. in November, 7.15% in December, 7.30% in January, and 7.10% in February. Now here we need to find out the evapotranspiration. Now here we need to find out the evapotranspiration. Here the T is the transpiration and E is the evaporation. We can find out the evapotranspiration by using Cu equals to K into F. Here K is the crop factor and Cu is the consumptive use factor. Okay. For finding out the consumptive use factor, F equals to P by 40 into 1.8 times T plus 32. In question, he has mentioned P. P is nothing but the percentage sunshine hours. And question, he has also mentioned temperature. T. Here it is equals to 7.20 by 40 into 1.8 into what is the temperature in November? 18 degree. 18 plus 32. In December it is 7.15 by 40 into 1.8 into what is the temperature in December? It is 15 degree plus 32. Next, in January it is 7.30 by 40 into 1.8 times the what is the temperature in January? It is 13.5 plus 32. Similarly, in case of February, 7.10 by 40 into 1.8 into the temperature is 14.5 plus 32. You will get the monthly consumptive use factor. It is equals to Now we have got the November consumptive use factor, December consumptive use factor, January consumptive use factor and February consumptive use factor. But here we need to find out the evapotranspiration for all these 4 months. So here we need to take summation consumptive use factor. It is, you need to add 11.6 plus 10.55 plus 10.27 plus 10.31. It will be around 42.73 will be the sigma F. Now you need to find out Cu. Cu is nothing but the consumptive use, or you can call it as evapotranspiration. Evapotranspiration. It is nothing but K into F. Here the value of K is given. It is 0.8, and the consumptive use factor sigma F equals to 42.73. If you multiply 0.8 into 42.73, you will get the consumptive use as 34.18 centimeter. We will get the consumptive as, or the evapotranspiration as 34.18 centimeter. It is the average consumptive use factor for this 4 months. Evapotranspiration occurring at 4 months, from November to February. Approximately 34.18 centimeter of evapotranspiration occurred. This is how you are going to find out the evapotranspiration. Okay, in next class we shall continue with infiltration. It is also one of the important losses. Okay, thank you.